as group discussion, seminar, and major project work. Before starting the discussion on rubrics, let us clear the difference between two terms, that is evaluation and assessment. Assessment is basically the process of measuring something with the purpose of assigning a numerical value. For example, if you given a class test and said that a student Ramesh had scored 8 marks out of 10, it means you are assessing your individual students in the class. And evaluation is the process of determining the worth of something in relation to established a benchmark using assessment information. For example, if you are ranking the students in a classroom, means you are evaluating or you are benchmarking the whole assessment process in the classroom. Evaluation can also be defined on 3 different classification, that is goal-based evaluation strategies, non-judgmental based evaluation strategies, and judgmental based evaluation strategies. Goal-based evaluation strategy means the process of determining to what extent the educational or instructional objectives are actually achieved by the students. Whereas in non-judgmental evaluation technique, it provides information for decision-making process or a systematic examination of a educational program. For example, if you given 3 assignments and told the student that out of these 3 assignments, 2 best assignments are considered for final evaluation, that is your non-judgmental type of evaluation technique. Whereas in judgmental type of evaluation technique, there's a systematic process of collecting, analyzing, interpreting information to determine the extent to which the students are achieving their instructional objective. In brief, assessment is basically to assigning a numerical value to a particular task given to the student, and evaluation means the attainment of the outcomes or step-by-step procedure for evaluating the achievement of student during your classroom instructions. Means evaluation is a technique for moment by moment, class by class, semester by semester, and course by course evaluation strategies for the student. Evaluation is product oriented, summative, comparative, and competitive. And rubrics is the useful tool for assessing or evaluating the student performance for a particular task assigned to them. Now start with the discussion on rubrics. In this particular topic, we're going to discuss, explain the concept of rubrics and its importance for evaluating the student performance, enlist various types of rubrics, explain various steps taken into consideration while designing a rubric, design scheme for the formation of the rubric for project work, group discussion, and seminars. First one is, what is rubric? A rubric is a scoring tool that is basically used for the evaluation purpose of a student. In this process, the rubric represents the performance expectation for an assignment or for a piece of the work. In the process of rubric, we divide the assignment into different components or different parts, and each component or part is well described in terms of the level of mastery given to the student. For example, if I'm going to assign a particular task or topic to each student for class presentation, what are my expectations as a teacher from them, or how will I evaluate my students on the basis of this rubric technique? For example, I will evaluate them on the basis of the content or information collected, on the basis of the delivery by each participant, or on the basis of their knowledge and class participation. Means rubric is simply defined as assign a particular task to the student, divide their task into number of scales and dimension. Those scales and dimension are assigned some numerical or particular value, and those particular tasks are well defined and described before giving the assignment to the student. Next is, what are the advantages of using rubrics? First one is, before starting the evaluation process, when we are using rubric, the parameters are well defined, so it helps in grading and evaluating consistently. Next is, the scores are to be given against each fixed parameter, so it's a time-saving process for a student and for a learner, student learner, or for a teacher also. Rubric is an easy way to evaluate long-term assignment, which include number of phases, for example, project work, teacher or instructor can easily identify those skills or concept in which students are weak and need more time and attention at their part. Rubric sheet is prepared and given to the student with the assignment so that they must know on what parameters their work is going to be evaluated, and student can monitor and assess their performance easily. After the assignment is scored and returned back to the student along with their rubric sheet, they can recognize their weakness and strength. There are different types of rubric available. First one is holistic type of the rubric. In this type of a rubric sheet, a single score is provided to the evaluation technique based on the overall impression of student performance or a task. For example, when you are dividing your whole assignment into number of activity and assign some numerical value on the basis of which the student are given marks, these type of rubrics are known as holistic rubrics. The advantages of these rubrics are, they are quick in their scoring process, provide overview of student achievement, allow effective scoring of overlapping component, and support broader judgment concerning the quality of the process of the or the product. Whereas disadvantages are, it does not provide detailed information, may be difficult to provide one overall score, it's analytical, journal, and very task-specific rubric. Next type of rubric is description type of the rubric. It provides specific feedback along several dimensions. Advantages are, it's more detailed feedback is given in these type of rubrics. Scoring more consistency across students, allow for separate evaluation of the various factors. Separate criteria can be scored on different descriptive scales. These type of rubrics are very time consuming rubrics to score. Next is journal type of the rubric. It contains criteria that are general across the task. Advantages are, can use the same rubric across different tasks, effectively assess a broad category of various tasks. Next is task-specific rubrics. It contains criteria that are general across the task. Advantages are, more reliable assessment of performance on the task, effective for measuring the acquisition of knowledge or skill, and disadvantages are, difficult to construct rubric for all specific tasks. Next will be, what is the format for a specific rubric? The rubric is divided into different components. The rubric sheet will contain for each individual student. First step for making a rubric is task description. For example, if I'm going to make a rubric sheet for tutorials, the task description will be evaluation of a tute sheet for Next step will be what are the various dimensions and aims used for preparing that evaluation sheet for a tute sheet. If I evaluate my students on the basis of dimension on the basis of which I am going to evaluate the student is understanding of concept, fourth one is if it is a numerical view, applicability of formula or concept solving the problems. Next is detail analysis for given problems. And last one is timely submission of various dimension on the basis of which rubric is prepared for tute sheet. Number of the scale used can be numerical type or descriptive type. Numerical type means for each dimension I'm going to assign some numerical value, and descriptive type means number of labels or terms are used classify the performance of the student. For example, if I am going to use numerical type of the scale and assign value for my various dimensions, for completeness of assignment I have given 2 marks, for thoroughness, understanding of concept, applicability of formula and or concept, detailed analysis and timely submission of tute sheet is 1. Total marks will be 10. On the basis of these parameters, I am going to evaluate the performance of a student for a given tute sheet. Next example is if I want to prepare a rubric sheet for class assignment, or say if I want to prepare my rubric sheet for lab work, evaluation of a lab work by using rubric as a evaluation technique, the various dimension used for evaluating black work art. First one is involvement in the experiment. Scale for this particular dimension is out of 5. Second one is understanding of theoretical concepts and implementation of those concepts while experimenting. Out of 4 marks. Third one is understanding of practical application. This is basically on the basis of 5 marks. Fourth one is maintaining lab level and use of resources such as material and space available in the lab area. For a single experiment, I use this rubric sheet and total 4 will be out of 15. This is the basic format for preparing rubric sheet. Next, we will discuss what are the various components of a rubric. What are the various components of a rubric sheet? There are 4 different components of the rubric sheet. First component is task description. First component is task description. It contains the criteria that journal across the rubric sheet, means either it's a descriptive type, journal type, task specific or holistic type of the rubric. The first step to prepare a rubric sheet is to define a task in a detailed manner. The task involves a performance of some sort of a student, means what are the various parameter or what are the specific goal which we are going to evaluate for a student performance. For example, it can be an assignment work, a tute sheet, major project work, class presentation or group discussion. Next component is scale. Scale describes how well or poorly any given task has been performed. Scale basically is to define a particular value, either numerical value, positive term, or any non-judgmental or descriptive term given to a particular activity or particular task. If it's a holistic type of a rubric, the scale used for preparing rubric sheet is always a numerical value. For descriptive, journal and general and task specific rubric sheet, different positive term, non-judgmental terms and some labels are used to describe the scale of the rubric sheet. Third component is dimension. Dimension is to divide a particular task or activity into number of components. Those components are well described. Those components are well described in terms of their mastery level. There are basic condition for defining the dimension in a rubric sheet. Divide the whole activity into excellent, good, and poor category at least to define or differentiate between the student performance for preparing a rubric sheet. Last one is the description of the dimension. Description of dimension means for each score or for each dimension, we have to assign some value or detailed category of the different tasks given to the students for preparing the rubric sheet. Next is, what are the various steps to create a rubric? First step is to identify the characteristics of what you are going to assess. For example, what is your description or what are the major goals to be identified for preparing the rubric sheet for evaluating student performance. Second step is, describe the best work you could expect using characteristics. This will describe top category, worst category, and medium category on the basis of which we are going to score the individual performance. Next is, develop description of intermediate level product and assign them to intermediate category. Basically, divide your task into number of parameters that can be excellent, good, very good, poor. Last one is, you might decide to develop a scale with 5 levels. These levels are unacceptable, marginal, acceptable, competent, outstanding, or into 3 levels that are competent, exemplary, or need improvement. Last one is, what is the checklist for effective rubric? First step is, does the rubric relate to the outcome being measured? Second is, if the assessment is to address critical thinking or skills, does the rubric reflect that? Does it cover the important dimension of the student performance? Do the criteria reflect current conceptions of excellence in the field? Does the rubric reflect what you emphasize in your teaching? Does the highest scale point represent a truly exemplary performance or product? Are the dimension or the scales are well defined? Is it clear to everyone what each scale measures? Is there a clear basis for assigning scores at each scale point, or is it clearly exactly what a student need to get a score to each scale point? Now let's prepare a rubric for a seminar. Divide this task into number of dimensions. For example, for a seminar, various dimensions are first one is presentation skills, second dimension will be information collected against use of latest technique of visual aids. Fourth dimension will be class participation. Third step for preparing a rubric sheet is define scales for various dimensions. For example, if I divide my scale into excellent, good, fair, and poor categories. Points such as good points, three marks, 2 marks, and 1 mark. If the total marks or total score will be from 10 points. Next step is define these dimensions descriptively. For example, in excellent category, if I define presentation skill into different component, such as in excellent category, the student will hold attention of entire audience with the use of direct eye contact, looking at the notes. Excellent communication skills. For good category, if I define this dimension, that is presentation skill, into consistent use of direct eye contact, speak with satisfactory variation of volumes, and good communication skills. Fair category into display less eye contact with the audience, reading partially from the notes, or speak in uneven volume. And last scale, that is poor. If I define communication or presentation skill into display minimum eye contact with the audience and speak with little or non-inflection voice, and assign the marks for each category, and at the end I will add the total marks. For example, if I'm going to evaluate an excellent student or excellent performance, I have given 3 points for presentation skills, 3 points for information collected, 2 points for visual aid, and 1 point for class participation. Means an excellent student will secure total 9 marks or 9 points out of 10 for a specific group seminar or group discussion. Likewise, for a poor student, if I am going to use this evaluation sheet, if he or she scores information collected, 1 mark in use of visual aids, and 0 mark in class participation, the total score for a poor student will be only 2 marks out of 10. In brief, for preparing a rubric, the first step is to describe a task The task can be a rubric sheet for a seminar, for a project work, for a tune sheet. Next step is to identify various dimensions on the basis of which the rubric is to be designed. The various dimensions are: for a specific seminar, for a classroom, the various dimensions are presentation skills, information collected, visual aid, and class participation, depending upon the judgment of teacher, evaluation. He or she can describe various dimensions for a particular task given. Next step is to assign a value or a scale for defined dimension. And last step is to describe each of the dimension into number of points for assigning marks to the student. This is the way how we prepare a rubric sheet. That's all about rubric sheet. Any question from the participant side? EC department?
No, ma'am.
MCA department, any question for rubrics? MCA department, any question on this topic? MCA department? Am I audible to MCA department? Now I request all the participants to divide yourself into two or three groups and prepare a rubric for a major project. The time given for this assignment is 15 minutes. MCA department, any question for rubric topic? Now I request all the participants to divide yourself into two or three groups and prepare a rubric sheet for a major project work. The time given for this assignment is 15 to 20 minutes. और एमसी में कौन है? ईसी डिपार्टमेंट सर, आर यू क्लियर विद द गिवन टास्क फॉर द असाइनमेंट?
यस मैम।
ओके फाइन।
Thank you. आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही मैम हमारे पास, वी कांट हियर यू।
एम आई ऑडिबल सर नाउ?
या नाउ यू आर ऑडिबल
सर। मे आई नो हु इज गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट फॉर अ रूब्रिक?
यस, आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग फॉर वन ग्रुप।
फॉर वन ग्रुप?
यस।
यू स्टार्ट योर प्रेजेंटेशन नाउ?
या
यू नीड मोर टाइम?
यस, सो आई मीन द फर्स्ट some marks will be allotted for assessment of need of the project.
Need of the project, okay. Your first dimension will be need of the project.
Yes.
Next.
Then will be project design and logic behind the project.
Identification of problem basically.
Yes, identification of the problem. Then the third one is implementation of the project.
Implementation, next.
Then outcome of the project.
Outcome of the project.
Then cost and efficiency of the project.
Cost and efficiency of project work.
Yes ma'am. Then is future scope.
Future scope.
After that, I mean those formalities, you can say basically there's a presentation of the project, how the students
are. These are the dimensions for preparing rubric sheet of project work, na?
Yes ma'am.
And what are the various scales used for this preparation?
I mean the number I mean the most of the part is distributed on the top four as need of project, project design, implementation and outcome. I mean let us say it is 100 marks. I will be giving 80 marks for these four.
80 marks. Equal distribution in these four parameters?
Yes ma'am, you can say 20-20.
And for cost and efficiency and future scope, 10-10 marks?
No ma'am. Cost and efficiency 10 marks and outcome 10 marks. These two include 10 marks. Then presentation, report and some regular, I mean continuous evaluation.
Punctuality, okay.
Punctuality.
Presentation, report and punctuality?
10 marks.
10 marks. You are going to prepare a rubric for a whole project work only in a single sheet, na?
Yes ma'am.
Any other group going to present for this sheet?
Any other group?
One is for the all the writing purpose like format, report making, PPTs, and presentation.
PPTs and
presentation. And second one is how they have done the work. Actually, whatever the work they have done, like the idea. How innovative and how new the idea is. Is it beneficial for the society? Whether it could be implemented for the practical purposes in the industry or not?
Basically, feasibility analysis.
Feasibility analysis.
Any other dimension?
With the least number of components and with better efficiency.
And scales used for these dimensions?
Ma'am, both 60-40, 60, if it is a 100, 60 for the idea, the first, second part, and 40 is for the report part, like your PPT presentation and report is for 40 marks, and the rest of the thing, how they have done the work and what is their idea, feasibility, that's everything.
Okay, ma'am. From MCA department, any participant would like to present on this topic? From MCA department, any participant would like to present on this topic? MCA department, am I audible to you? Okay, EC department, some feedback on your rubric sheet. First of all, when we are going to evaluate for a project work, basically in colleges, the evaluation for a project work is divided into three parts. First one is presentation. First part for a project work is synopsis presentation. Second evaluation is mid-semester evaluation, and the last phase, that is phase number 3, is final presentation for a project work. Basically, in phase 1, the dimension described for preparing a rubric sheet is, first one is if I want to prepare a rubric sheet for a project work for phase 1, the task will be rubric sheet for a synopsis presentation of a major project work. The various dimensions according to me are second dimension will be information collection, or you can say the greater
sub. Ma'am, you are not audible. Neither it is visible what you are writing. It is not audible, neither it is visible.
So for presentation work, in engineering colleges, the evaluation is conducted into three different phases. Am I audible, sir, now?
Yes, ma'am, now you are audible.
First one, we can say synopsis presentation. For synopsis presentation, according to my judgment, if I define various dimensions like, first one is objective of the research, second will be information collected, that you can say literature survey or background study of the identified problem. Third dimension will be visibility analysis. Visibility analysis will include work break success. Next parameter will be material or resources available for research purpose. Fourth dimension will be presentation of phase 1, that is our synopsis part. And last dimension will be class participation. question answer session. This is the rubric sheet that I have been prepared for my first part of evaluation of a project work. The various scales used for this type of presentation are, for example, if I divide these dimensions into four different scales, A, B, C, and I divided A 10 marks, A 6, and 4 marks. Next, rubric sheet is for phase 2, that is, task description will be mid-semester evaluation. In mid-semester evaluation, first dimension will be planning phase. Planning phase for identified objectives. Second will be use of sustainable use of materials or resources available. Third will be use of latest techniques or industrial applications in the project. Fourth and fifth parameter will remain same as phase one, that is class participation. Again, I divided these dimensions into parameters, that is A, B, C, and D, and assigned some numerical value for easy assessment of the rubric sheet. Last rubric sheet which I prepared for a major project is final evaluation of a project work. In final of the various parameters considered are, first one is organization of the whole concept, implementation of the designing or planning phase, next is subject knowledge, followed by question answer session by the committee as well as the other class students. Next is multimedia, uses on use of latest technology. And last one is evaluation of overall research that includes completeness of the project according to work-based structure, coverage of the concepts, and last one is conclusions with justification. These are the three different rubric sheet which we can prepare for evaluation of a project. Any question from the participant side? MCA department, any question? EC department, any question or doubt, or would you like to add something to these rubric sheets?
There is no marks for report writing.
The report writing is basically in phase 1 and phase 2. The class participation means submission of the report, presentation skill, and question answer session.
Ma'am, how you can evaluate the report in phase 1 itself? Unless and until one complete the project, we cannot evaluate the report.
Sir, in first phase, we have to identify the basic problems of the project work.
Yes, that is fine, ma'am.
And in phase two, there is a proper work-based structure and report submission in a second phase too. And in third phase, where we are concluding the research, completeness means overall implementation of your designing and planning phase. Coverage means your report writing, your presentation skills. And conclusion with justification means conclusion as well as recommendation and future scope of the study problem. In our fourth dimension, in which coverage is covered, the report session is covered under this title.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Any other doubt?
No, ma'am, that's all.
MCA department? MCA department, would you like to add something?
No, ma'am, don't want to ask any questions. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible. Any question or
no,
any
ma'am.
Doubt?
No, ma'am.
Have you guys prepared a rubric sheet for a major project work?
Sorry?
Have you guys prepared a rubric sheet for a major project work?
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir, you are audible. क्या आप लोगों ने कोई रूब्रिक शीट बनाया मेजर प्रोजेक्ट वर्क के लिए सर अभी तक
मैम वी हैव मेजर प्रोजेक्ट इन द 6th सेमेस्टर ऑफ आवर डिग्री राइट इन आवर डिपार्टमेंट
सर आई एम आस्किंग हैव यू प्रिपेयर्ड अ रूब्रिक शीट फॉर अ मेजर प्रोजेक्ट वर्क द टास्क एनी क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दिस टॉपिक आस्क योर पार्टिसिपेंट्स प्लीज
Ma'am, I have one more doubt.
Yes, sir.
How will you differentiate between a hardware implemented project and simulated project? I mean, according to the rubric sheets which you have given us, I mean, which points covers those area?
So can you please repeat your statement?
I want to ask, how will I differentiate between a project, one which is hardware implemented and the one is implemented in some software tools?
Sir, in phase two, while preparing rubric sheet in phase two, that there is a dimension called planning phase. In planning phase, you will describe or differentiate your project work. Either it's a hardware-based project or a software-based project. Depending upon the type of the project, the dimension or scales are to be defined. And before the evaluation of the student, the rubric sheet must be given to the student so that they must know on what basis they are going to evaluate or assess their performance.
So can you explain planning phase once again?
Planning phase, sir, for example, if you are going to use some kind of a software in your project work. According to that, your planning phase will describe different kind of activities, means on what phases or on what areas or at what time your project will use, the student will use the software part of the project. Or in case of a hardware project, is there any prototype or a model the students are going to generate during their project work. Depending upon their assignment, you will define the dimension and scale those dimensions accordingly. Rubric is basically a judgment evaluation sheet prepared by the teacher and given to the student for their, before their evaluation.
Thank you, ma'am.